In today's video, we're covering the color editor inside of ON1 Photo RAW. Now, as always, if you'd like to download the sample files, you can do so using the link in the description box below. Now, let's jump into it. Now, before we dive too deep, I just want to make you aware that the color editor tool was added to ON1 Photo RAW in 2025. So if you have an earlier version than the 2025 version and you want to follow along, you're not going to find the color editor tool in your filters listing. Now, of course, if you want to save some money and pick up ON1 Photo RAW 2026, consider using the coupon code found in the description box below. Those are affiliate coupons and links. Just means I make a small commission from everyone who uses it, but it's at no extra charge to you. It's a win-win and a great way of supporting the channel. So here we are inside of ON1 Photo RAW 2026 with a photo of our color wheel. And this is just going to help us understand what the color editor is actually doing to our image. Now, before we dive into it, I do want to make a little bit of a note to separate the color editor from the color mixer and the color enhancer, which is the color editor works with one specific color and it's a more subtle approach to editing that color. All right, so let's go ahead and unpack how the color editor actually works. If I go ahead and click this to expand my menus here, you'll see I have opacity and styles. We're not gonna spend time on those. Those are the same as all other filters inside of ON1. But if I click on color editor, this will expand. Now, I get a few options available to me here and we're gonna go through these relatively quick, but I promise it's gonna make sense. So the first one is the eye picker. And this is where you want to actually start because you gotta tell ON1 what color you want to manipulate. So I'm just gonna go ahead and click this little eyedropper and I'm gonna click right here in this little orange cell. Now you'll notice that once I clicked it, it popped up this little selection on the color wheel. Well, if I need to see exactly what colors are being selected in my image, ON1 has given us this little visualize color tool. So if I click on it, it's going to show me all of the areas that have been selected by what color I just clicked on. So essentially, I am impacting, or I have selected right now, everything that you see that's saturated. Anything that's desaturated, I have not selected, which means when I make these adjustments, it is not going to impact those areas. Now, let's say I wanted to get more of this green over here. Well, that's where this color wheel comes in handy. I'm gonna grab this little node out here, and this is where yellows are, so that's represented here on the actual color wheel photo. If I drag this over to the left, you'll notice that when I let it go, I've selected more of this green, and then this is even starting to get a little bit more saturation in there as well. So this is a very powerful tool for precise edits. And let's see if I can maybe get rid of this little red area here. So I'll grab the orange node and I'll pull that in just a little bit, and you can see how that starts to go away. So now I've only selected these areas right here, and maybe I want to get rid of that green, so I'll just go ahead and pull this in just a little bit as well. All right, this is one of those things you want to play around with to get familiar with how this tool is actually working. Now, another aspect of this particular tool is deciding how much saturation is actually being selected, and you can do that by hovering over the innermost sphere or portion of the color wheel here, and then you can drag that up and you can drag it back. Now when I let it go, you'll notice that I am no longer selecting the less saturated portions of that color space that we have selected here. So again, very, very fine adjustments for precise editing inside of ON1 Photo RAW. Now I'm going to pull that all the way out and make sure that I have the full range of saturation being selected. Now it doesn't look like it did anything. So sometimes what you have to do is click the little eyeglasses and then click them again and you get that visualization back. So doesn't always update right away, but that's a way of resetting that visualization. Underneath the color wheel, we get the hue, saturation, and brightness values of the color that we sampled. So if you're looking for a very specific color and you know that, then you can definitely fine tune it by getting these numbers to look exactly what you need them to be. But in most cases, you can just ignore that aspect of the tool here because nobody really edits that way in most cases, all right? Then we get into something that is hopefully more familiar, especially if you watch the color mixer video that I've already posted. If you haven't, just check the links in the description box. Now, with that being said, the first one here is feather, and this is how precise to that color do we want it to select. And you'll notice that in the color wheel, that feather ring kind of it gets tighter, so we have a more accurate selection of those colors. However, colors, they kind of fade into one another, and so you usually want to have some sort of a feather, so that way when you make your adjustments, it makes sense. Now, with the feather up to 100%, you'll notice we're starting to get those surrounding colors again that maybe we didn't really want. So we can just pull down on this feather until we get to the points of the color space that we actually want to manipulate. So now that we understand what the heck feather is doing to our image, let's take a look at hue, saturation, and lightness. All right. These are very common tools that are found in pretty much all of the color editing tools because these are the three components that make up a color. The hue is just the color that we call it, so no different than any other tool. If I pull this to the left, then I'm making this orange a little bit more green, and if I pull it to the right, I'm making the orange a little bit more orange. That's all that the hue is doing, super easy to understand. Then we have saturation. Now, saturation is like the volume slider of color. So if I pull up on the saturation, you can see things just get a little bit more filled in here. And if I pull down on the saturation, things get less filled in or less color added to them. Now, you can double click any of these nodes to reset them to their default position that ON1 gives them. All right. It's a good way of just getting back to the default for that one slider. Then you can come down to lightness, and lightness is just how dark or how bright do you want to make a color? So you can see exactly how powerful this tool really is. Now, my recommendation is you fine tune the color that you're going for in the visualize mode that we're in now. But after you've made your fine tune, so let's say I want to make these a little bit darker, a little bit more saturated, and a little bit more orange because I wanted that orange to just really like come through, right? Now, if I turn off this visualize color, I can see what it looks like with the surrounding colors in the image. Harmony matters when it comes to editing your photos. So if I go ahead and turn this color editor off and on, you can see how it just makes these a little bit more saturated and a little bit darker in just this tonal range of the color wheel. So now that we know how the color editor works, let's take a look at how we can use it on a photo. All right, so here we are on an image, and we're gonna take a look at how the color editor works. But if you're finding value, go ahead and smash that like button and hit subscribe if you are not already subscribed. Before we look at the color editor, let's take a look at tone and color because I did manipulate just the tone. I did not touch anything down here in the color section of the photo, just the tone and the structure. Those are the only adjustments that I've made. So here's what the before image looks like, and here is what the after image looks like. Now, of course, if you're following along, you're going to have those settings already applied to the image, but I want to show you that this is what you need to do to your image first. Develop your tone and get the base look that you want to work with. Now, we can jump over to the effects section. And you'll see I already have a color editor added in just to save us a little bit of time. And so we'll go ahead and activate it. It doesn't do anything because I haven't selected my color yet. So I'm going to click the eye picker tool. And I want to work with these greens, and I want to make them a little bit more harmonious with the beak of the eagle here. So I'm just going to click and sample, maybe right here, sample this green. And I'm going to hit the little eyeglasses so I can visualize the color in my photo. So let's just go ahead and click the eyeglasses. And it looks like I didn't actually click anything, but I assure you I did. You'll notice that the beak, it gets desaturated there. So what I want to do is focus more on just the greens in the photo, not any of the yellows. So I'm going to come over here to the node on the outside of my color wheel, and I'm just going to pull that in and then drop it. And I'm looking at the beak to make sure that the beak isn't saturated or selected. So I'm just going to keep pulling that in. And now I have a pretty good selection of the greens here. All right, so let's just turn that off. And I'm sorry, we'll leave it on because we want to start working with how we want these greens to move, right? So what I need to do is work with the hue, and I want the greens to probably be, let's just go a little bit more green than they probably need to be for show purposes, and then we'll fine tune it. All right, so I'll pull my hue closer to the greens, and then I will pull my saturation over to the right to pump up the volume on the color. And then I want these to be a little bit darker so the eagle can kind of shine through in the image. So I'll pull down on the lightness. So I've made some very stark changes here. Let's go ahead and turn off the glasses to take a look at the image. And so let's take a look at the before. This is without the color editor. And then the after. This is with the color editor. Now, this is an extreme case, and I really wanted to just show how you can manipulate this. What I would probably do in this case is pull the hue over to the right just a little bit. But notice this is a very, very subtle adjustment. This isn't like a massive color change like we would get with the color mixer. The color editor is really specific to one hue of color, because you are determining the color range right here. Now, this would be similar to using the range slider on the color mixer or the color enhancer, but you're able to visualize exactly where that left and right limit is based off of moving those nodes. You can also choose exactly how saturated of a color that you want to manipulate. So now that we understand the color editor tool, let's talk use cases, because this is a relatively niche tool. And I think that only two categories is where this fits. The first one is if you want to be just completely creative. Like, you just want to change a color and make that color look a little bit different, but you don't want to affect anything else around it, then that's how you can remap the color using this tool. Or the second category, which is where I think many people will use this tool, is for corrective things. So if your image has a really weird cast in a specific color range, then you can just use this tool, hone in on that color range, and maybe you want to desaturate that color. So you can just pull back on the color, mute everything, and make the image look a little bit different or correct what color cast is in the image. That's what the color editor is primarily used for. And I think that that's how I would recommend to people to use it. You let me know in the comment section how you would use this tool. Now, if you want to save money when you shop over at the ON1 store, consider using the coupon code and the links in the description box below. Those are affiliate links. That just means I make a small commission at no extra charge to you. It's a win-win when you use those links. If you got questions, let me know in the comments section. And until next time, I want you to stay inspired and keep creating. Peace.